Construya su video rocola.
Assembly of the amplifier in its box or chassis. Next, you will see the sixth and final video of the project, 400 watts amplifier for jukebox. To be make this project, the first thing you should do, is watch the video, of the 400 watt stereo amplifier 2.0 version. Build an electric transformer. Tone and volume control, with microphone preamplifier. Wired remote volume control. The Zobel network. And build the chassis for 400 watt amplifier. Procedure. Having already built all the parts of this project, begin by securing the power supply capacitors. For this, is used hot silicone gun. You keep in mind, that these capacitors are quite heavy, and over time, the vibration can eventually fracture the welds. To ensure good cooling, use a 12 volts and 3.5 inch diameter cooler fan. This is indispensable, since the amplifier will be placed into the video jukebox. Draw the holes, through which will pass the screws that will hold the cooler fan. For this, can use a wooden stick which is immersed in paint. Drill the two holes, using a 4mm drill bit. Must thoroughly clean any aluminum particles that may have fallen over the cart. These can cause short circuits. Secure the fan using plate screws. Now, to power the cooler fan, use the additional 17 volts AC winding. As the fan works with DC current, and the transformer delivers AC current, place the diode in series with the positive, with the cathode of the diode, towards the positive input of the cooler fan. Thus, the fan will only see the positive half cycles, and will work without problems. Connect the fan to the transformer, using 2.54 mm Molex connectors. The male connector is welded to the fan, and the female connector is welded to the transformer, so that the power cable does not fracture with the edge of the sheet, place a cable gland. It is gently inserted into the hole, with the help of a screwdriver. Place the fuse holder in place. This is secured with a plastic washer and a nut. It is tightened slightly, with the help of a needle plier. Now place all the spacer support, or plastic fasteners for PCB, that will support the Zobel net, and the amplifier mainboard. Place the Zobel network. As we see, this is supported by four supports. Place the amplifier mainboard. It ensures the PCB supports have the advantage that being of plastic material, they do not conduct the electricity, so we keep the cards isolated from the box and in turn ensures a good grip. Now connect the speaker's output to the Zobel network input. The speaker's pressure connector is placed in the respective hole. And connect it to the Zobel network output. The connector is secured with screws and nuts. The next step is to install the transformer. Hold it to the box with screws, washers, and nuts. And connect the main output of the transformer into the power input of the amplifier mainboard. Here have the sticker with the drawing of controls and inputs of the card, tones control, and microphone preamplifier. On our website, you can download a Corel Draw file which contains this design. Cut the sticker. Then, stick the decal on the box, taking care that it matches perfectly the holes through which the potentiometers and jacks will come out. Now, with the help of a scalpel, cut the adhesive paper, uncovering the holes. Proceed to place the tones control. Secured the jacks with their respective nuts. Placed the potentiometer washers. And secure them with the nuts. Now, connect the additional transformer winding to the power input of the tones control. Put the female RCA connector of the signal input. It is secured with two self-tapping screws. The signal input connector connects to the tones control input. Continue with the signal cable, which goes from the tone control output to the amplifier input. To make the previous connections, we had to remove the fan, so we place it back in place. And reconnect the transformer to the cooler fan. Now, the power cable is connected as follows. Insert the cable tip or opposite end of the plug into the hole in the case, from the outside to the inside. Make a knot to avoid that when pulling the cable by accident, they misread the connections. Separate the two cables. To one of the cables, remove 3 or 4 millimeters of insulation. Apply tin on the tip. And weld the cable to the terminal of the end of the fuse holder. The other wire of the power cable is connected to one of the wires of the transformer. Remove the insulation. We weld. Do the same with the other end of the power cable. Introduce the piece of heat shrinking spaghetti. And join both ends, joining and melting the weld until achieving a perfect union. Now, place the heat shrink spaghetti on the union and apply heat so that it contracts. leaving perfectly isolated the welded union. The other cable of the transformer input is connected to the terminal of the center of the fuse holder. In this case, the amplifier does not have a switch, since the amplifier is turned on when the stabilizer or multi-power outlet of the jukebox is turned on. Now proceed to place a fuse of 4 amperes inside the fuse holder. Finally, place a knob on each of the axes of each potentiometer. This gives a good presentation. We already have our 400 watts amplifier for the video jukebox. Now listen to the sound test. We place the amplifier inside the video jukebox. The power cable connects to the multi-power outlet or general power. The end of the signal cable that the plug has connects to the PC audio output. And the other end, which has the male RCA connectors, connects to the amplifier signal input. Connect the remote volume control. And connect the speakers to the amplifier outputs. Now, after turn on the jukebox, insert the coin and select a song.
We invite you to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Go to the toll button and check the box Send Me Updates. Join us on Facebook. And follow us on Twitter. Visit our website construyasuvideorocola.com.